FM News. On point.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Lynn Komjisha. Let's take a look at the news. President Yoweri Museveni says the government will generate a lot of revenue from air transport after bringing on board an Airbus that will make non-stop flights. Museveni says tourists, Ugandan travelers in and abroad, cargo, among others, will travel without much inconveniences and unnecessary stopovers at certain airports. He made the remarks after receiving the first Uganda Airbus, which has a seating capacity of 250 passengers.
This new airline will not only help us with the convenience for our own travelers, the diaspora, they were really being inconvenienced. Then we have the tourists who don't have to stop here, stop there, they will come direct. Then cargo, we are getting discriminatory rates. A kilo of flowers or fruits from A pays so much. Can you imagine? And a kilo of Ugandan things pays more. This is really unchristian. I don't like that type of thing. So now, I haven't checked, but I'm sure there is a cargo capacity here. Is that correct? 31 tons of cargo. Oh, that's something. 21. Oh, okay. So, you people of Nanasi, of Bogoya, we can help those people of Europe with good bananas. So, we're going to
Museveni, however, warned the management Uganda Airlines Company against corruption.
I congratulate Ugandans for having their own airline and the staff. I ask you to fight corruption. Don't allow corruption in the new airline. I don't want to hear a smell of corruption in the new Uganda Airlines. So I thank you, and I thank the Airbus for making a good product. We were wise not to buy the other American one. You remember the other American one? The Boeing, which has been crushing and killing people. So Katonda Jari is the one who guided us. Thank you so much. It's now my pleasure to commission the airline.
The Interreligious Council of Uganda has urged presidential candidates to avoid insults during campaigns, but rather focus on issues affecting the common person. While launching their pastoral letter on COVID-19, its impact and possibilities for nation building, the religious leaders asked candidates to present what they have in their manifestos for the good of Ugandans, instead of pointing fingers at each other. The Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Stephen Kazimba Mugalu, who represented the council chairman, Sheikh Ramadan Mubaje, called on Ugandans to promote the spirit of working together for people rather than fighting each other over candidates they support.
As religious leaders, we do continue to discourage because it's not good for our people. Uganda, which was built on a very good motto, for God and my country, it is calling for peace, it's calling for reconciliation, forgiveness, but also presenting what you would like to do for the Ugandans. So this is what we would like to encourage.
The council has also announced that they will not be able to hold presidential debates, as was the case in 2016, because they lack financial support and candidates are busy campaigning, as Charles Kasivante explains.
We are going to miss that element within these elections because the country will not be able to hear from their candidates what they think about different issues, what they are preparing for the country, and on a wider scale, because the media brings the candidates to a wider body that view them and listen to them to hear what they have to say above this time. It will not be possible.
Now, police has warned all party and event organizers to desist from organizing any events during the festive season. Kampala Metropolitan Police P.R.O. Patrick Onyango says that they have been reading and listening to some of the adverts online and other platforms telling people to attend these events, which is wrong. Onyango has indicated that anyone who organizes or participates in these events will be arrested. He appealed to the public to report people organizing such parties and events in hotels, at the beaches, and in houses.
We want to warn the organizers of these parties and stop advertising for the events. We also warn any person that will attend such events that will be arrested for breaching the laws.
In other news, this cold morning, Israel is to hold its fourth elections in 2 years after the two main parties in its unity government failed to meet a deadline in a row of a state budget. Voters will return to the polls in March, just 12 months after the last round. Two previous elections were inconclusive, resulting in a rare government of national unity. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, on trial for alleged corruption, is hoping to return to office for a sixth time. He denies the criminal charges against him, dismissing them as politically motivated. At midnight, 2200 GMT, Israel's parliament, the Knesset, was automatically dissolved as required by law after a deadline to pass the 2020 state budget expired. An 11th hour attempt to avoid this failed attempt after a bill to allow more time was voted down against expectations. That was the news.
It's FM News on point.